Alrighty, welcome to Vintage Cube Draft here on channelfireball.com. And what do we got? We've got Ponder, we've got High Tide, we've got Wooded Foothills. Hey, what up? High five from Ryan. High five. Yeah, no power yet today, but we'll see. This pack is probably not strong enough to wheel High Tide. And I have to kind of decide whether I want to take the responsible pick, which I think Ponder's probably your best win percentage overall. And then, but I love High Tide. Hey, Gray Fox, welcome to the divination. You know what? I'm going to take High Tide because that's where I want to be. Ooh, look at that. So now that we have High Tide, we have a couple options here. I think I'm going to take Misty. The reason is High Tide decks really want to have all islands in play. I actually like Dryad with High Tide as well. That's actually a combo. And Misty really helps you draft blue-green, which I think is the best High Tide deck in general, besides mono-blue. There's also a Grim Monolith, but honestly, I'm not even that impressed with Grim Monolith. I think Grim Monolith is fine, but it's not insane. All right, there we go. Look, Sakura Tribe Elder. I love that in the blue-green High Tide decks, because it's a speed bump, buys you a turn, gets an extra island into play, fixes your mana, does everything you need. Hey, what up, John Watts? Welcome back. 43 months. There's also Tireless Tracker, Basalt Monolith. I'm going to a little rant here. Basalt Monolith, people seem to put it in the same category as Grim Monolith and, you know, Worn Power Stone and these cards like that. And it's just worse than all of them. Basalt Monolith sucks. Like, it's playable in some decks, don't get me wrong, but it's not a premium card. I'm going to take Dig Through Time. I've actually been really impressed with Dig Through Time, really unimpressed with the fact that they still have a bunch of art that is incomprehensible. But I'm going to take Dig Through Time over Courser. And I don't think that's particularly close given my High Tide pick here. Hey, what's up, AGLVI? I also have to like do the mental math, and you're like, ah, that's Adam, whereas Rebecca is a Jolipa. So, boom. Oh yeah, this is a good start. This is exactly where we want to be. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I do have. See, look, I got the Dig Through Time art behind me there. Wait, there. I'm like really struggling here. There. Yeah, I solved it. Rusty Venture, welcome back. 9 month resub. See, like normally you'd Moldrifter over Thirst because this draws you more cards. Here, I think it's defensible to consider Thirst for Knowledge because it just, this is more card advantage rather. It draws you two cards but leaves a body to play or is just a divination. Whereas Thirst is a draw three, you see three new cards, which I think is more valuable here. So I'm gonna take Thirst. Good with Dig Through Time as well. Oh, there's the Turnabout. There's the Skipper. Turnabout to go with my High Tide. There's also a Thousand Year Storm. BK's crying out in the distance somewhere. Nucleosynth, welcome back. 29 months. This isn't that. Indeed a stream. Moldified with the 44-month resub and the Weird One. Welcome back. 60 months. 5 years? Oof, the Weird One. I don't know. I don't know how I kept you for 5 years, but I appreciate it. I appreciate the 5 years of support and hopefully enjoying some nice cube streams here, as we are doing now. That's so cool. And Liang, welcome back. 42-month resub. And Petit Drogo, welcome to the divination. Welcome, everyone. We are having a good time here. We're taking a Heartbeat of Spring. This is just classic blue-green storm. And we're early enough in the draft that haven't seen any people saying, hey, you don't have a win condition yet. But don't worry. We're going to get to the point in the draft where people want me to take win conditions. And then later in the draft, I'll probably find one. What else we got here? Probably not going to play Gush, but I don't think I'm playing any of these other cards. Gush, if I end up with exactly fast one, could be playable, but you just don't want to bounce lands in your deck that's filled with ways to untap them. Johnny Cats, 33 months. Oh, welcome back. I'm going to take Bayou here in case I want you to splash a Demonic Tutor or something like that. And here, I'm probably going to take Show and Tell. I'm not that likely to run it, but I'm not going to run Razor Verge Thicket. I think Mastermind's Acquisition is just generally not good. And Show and Tell sometimes can combine with something like if we did wheel Thousand Year Storm, something along those lines. I actually think I'm going to take Thragtusk here. Against Mono Red, I'd rather side in Thragtusk. I don't think I'm going to Mindslaver, and I don't think I'm in the like Progenitus Autarkus camp right now. Hey, what up, BK? You've been sub for 58 months, but there's a 44-month streak, which means at some point there, I see what happened. Welcome back, BK. Always a pleasure. How do you like... I know you like the deck. I'm not going to even ask you. This is exactly what you want to be doing. Hossman 83, 70 months. Ooh, you're working on, yeah, you're getting close to a commander territory there. 71 is more than most formats, but not quite enough for a commander. I appreciate it, Hossman. I'm glad you've stuck around. I'm glad you're still enjoying the stream. Take the Quagmire, though. Not likely to play any of these. I'm not actually unhappy. Oh, there we go. Pick up a late Lotus Bloom and a Thousand-Year Storm. There we go. So, Parney, once you first pick an early High Tide, that's a great question. What are you looking to see? You're looking to see untap effects like Turnabout, Frantic Search. Time Spiral is the absolute best card with High Tide. It's a two-card combo that requires High Tide, four islands, and a Time Spiral, and that already gives you seven cards and eight mana, but with implications of much, much more. Oh, last pick, Acidic Slime. So green's probably open, which means I might pick up the green cards I want, which are cards like Cultivate, less cards like Llanowar Elf. Eldraine 23, welcome back with the 2 month resub. Deliri Knight, welcome to the Divination. If I missed anyone, let me know. Mm-hmm. Fast Bond would not be bad. I'm gonna take Mox Jet here. Mox Jet's still good. You still get to play Turn One Elder. Also, now I have three free black sources plus Lotus Bloom, so that's not unreasonable. I am also looking at nothing else here as a card I really want to put in my deck. Maybe Emrakul, because sometimes you can just get a bunch of mana in Emrakul, but I don't know. Oh yeah, Oracle of Muli Dulu would be nice. Oh, I didn't wheel the Dryad. It's okay, I'll live without the Dryad, but it would have been nice to wheel it. Thassa's Oracle is a great win condition for these decks. I really like the inclusion of, there we go, Thassa's Oracle. I might actually take it here. The thing is, it almost always wheels. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6-ish, 7, 8, 9. It'll probably wheel. Oh, Kelsey, thanks for the bits. I appreciate that. Boom, boom, boom. Basically, I'm looking at what would I take if I did not want to take the Thassa's Oracle. It would probably just be Dimir Signet. Hey, what's up, Morty's Dog? Welcome back with the 8 month resub or repeal. Neither of those. The thing is, Riftwing is fine, but it's not actually that great in the Storm deck. It's not really what you want. I don't want Marsh Flats. It's very far away from where I want to be here. This is close. Maybe I just take the Riftwing anyway. Deluge is actually not bad. BK is not wrong about that. He's really not. Yeah, this is tough. I'll just take the Cloudscape. Maybe it'll be fine. Oh, now we have Witness and Wake. I probably don't need Wake because I have Heartbeat and High Tide. There's also Glennonald. The Glennalandra Archmage is pretty good because you just play it and it's a good blocker. Keeps them off whatever they're doing, and lets you just basically, you know, kind of run interference for your main plan. There's also a Wheel of Fortune, which is not unreasonable. I don't think Verdant Catacombs is really going to... I mean, it's not bad, but it's not really going to help me without a blue-black or blue-green duel. Hey, Russell Nash, welcome back to 16 months. This pack's hard, too. There's a lot of, like, medium cards. Witness is really good with, like, Turnabout High Tide. But I think Glenn is probably just more what this deck wants. Plus, this deck would rather play as many blue cards as possible and as few green cards as possible. So a double green card is not really what I want. I think I'm going to take Spellseeker here because it goes and gets High Tide. Plus, usually, you'll pick up more targets by the end of it as well. And, ooh, I actually really like Commit Memory. It's perfect in these style of decks because you keep up Commit on, like, say, turn 4, turn 5. You get to... stop them from doing whatever they're doing, and then you just flashback memory later. There's also Brainstorm, which I really like, a Thousand-Year Storm, but if our deck's good enough, then we might not have to play Thousand-Year Storm. BK, don't listen. Ooh, the Mirari Conjecture, so I can get back a High Tide or a Thirst. Okay, I've got a bunch of instants. I don't have really many sorceries yet. There's also Shark Typhoon, which is just a little defensive card. Hey, what's up, RM Coat? Welcome back. 19 months resub. I hope you enjoy the cube and dinner. I've actually had Shark Typhoon in play, like you hard cast it and then you go off, and that's pretty cute too. I think Mirari Conjecture tends to be better with a bunch of removal, not a bunch of storm cards. It is great with Time Walks. I think I'm going to take Shark Typhoon, though. I put a high value on cards like Commit Memory, Shark Typhoon, that just let you... Cryptic Command is great with that. That let you kind of delay them killing you or beating you while also drawing cards or having other effects. You want things that do both. You don't want Fatal Push Doomblade effects as much as you want like repeal effects. All right, I'm going to take Time Warp here. That's pretty easy Time Warp over like Bloodstained Mire or whatever. Oh, man, I was looking at the V-Click and I was happy, but there's also a Regrowth and a Brain Freeze. I think I'm just going to take the Brain Freeze. It's the best win condition in these. Well, I guess Thassa's Oracle. The thing is, it's really good with Thassa's Oracle too. Oh man, this pack has every card I want. The last card's going to be Eidolon of Obstruction when it comes back. I think I'm just going to take Brain Freeze, though. Brain Freeze is great. I really do hope to wheel that Thassa's Oracle. Here's the pack that had no cards I wanted. I'll put Nature's Claim in the sideboard here. Yeah, I want the Brain Freeze too, Squirrel. I think that's the pick. Thousand-Year Storm is not making it right now. Currently not necessary. Hey, Ryan. Yeah, no, playing Flesh and Blood has been fun. I've started to get into it. I've actually got like my setup where I film it all back here, and I've got all the decks and stuff, and it's cool. It's a fun game. Some of the cards are expensive. I will give you that. I'm really nervous about this Riftwing pick, because Riftwing I think is going to be fine here. It's one of those cards that's cheap disruption, but Thassa's Oracle is pretty important to the deck. Though getting Brain Freeze is nice. Though it's a combo with itself too, where sometimes you just go play three spells, Brain Freeze myself, play Thassa's Oracle. And that can be pretty nice too. I missed the question earlier, but I saw someone ask what do you think about putting in cards from the new sets? Because whenever a cube comes out after a set, they always include a bunch of the cards from the set, and often those cards stay for like one iteration because they're not actually good enough. I actually think that's fine. It makes sense to put cards. Oh, there we go. The repeal wheeled too, but we're definitely taking Thassa's Oracle. That was great. It's good to put in cards from the new set because it's good to, like, that's the whole point. Like, show off new cards is cool. It's a way to connect cube in the new set. Hey, Solon, welcome back to the 15-month resub. And I think I'm going to take Eternal Witness. I actually like Finale and decks that need win conditions, but this deck's looking like it's got its win condition pretty well set up. I think I'll take Tasigur or Vraska, whatever. Lake Ball Ritual. This deck's so far away from Cabal Ritual. I think I'm slightly more likely to play Blast Zone, though really don't see either of them coming in. I mean, yeah, I think that it's cool. You get to basically the barrier to including a cube is way lower for cards from the newest set, as it should be. I'm sure they even have like a mandate to be like include 10 cards or whatever it may be. But that's cool. You get to find new cards, and the ones that don't work, they rotate out. It's not that much damage dealt, you know. Lotus one time. I think Sol Ring would be better for this deck the way it's currently constructed, but I wouldn't complain about either. Hey, Clem, I am. Welcome back. 11 months. I'm just gonna take Foffers. Not really like that exciting, but Foff is fine. Cards like Foff make cards like Glen and Riftwing actually better because these buy you the time to cast your Foffs to set up. So I think that is perfectly reasonable. How not to draft. Welcome back. 45 months. Wabam. I am teaching you how not to draft right now. Actually, the card I would really like that I haven't seen yet is Frantic Search. Time Spiral and Frantic Search are the two cards I want the most here, I think. I don't really want it exactly, but I'm probably going to take Bribery, because sometimes you just go Suspend Bloom Bribery, or Turn 2 Sakura Tribe Elder, Turn 3 Mox Bribery, or Turn 4 Bribery, and that's just bam. Mm-hmm. All right, I take it. Oh, I don't like Oath. Oath doesn't really work in this deck, Zlubars. We're not going to Oath up anything. Yeah, exactly, Sam. I think that there's, first of all, the cue ball has plenty of cards you can cut. Whenever you try something and it doesn't work, it's easy enough to cut it. Second, when they do cut those cards, like, it's cool to try new ones, you know? So Mind's Desire is interesting. So I go High Tide, Turnabout. I don't have any Draw Sevens. That's what this deck... Oh, no, I do. Actually, I have Commit to Memory. Mind's Desire works well with Lotus Bloom. It's decent with Mox. It's decent with Turnabout. The other alternatives take Botanical Sanctum, Nissa. I don't think this is really a Metamorph for Findhorn Elves deck. I don't think I want Steam Vents. I know I have the Thousand Year Storm, but this isn't even really looking like a Thousand Year Storm deck. On the other hand, if I take Steam Vents, I could see whether Seething Song or Desire Wield. And maybe go from there. I think Steam Vent's slightly better than Botanical Sanctum for that reason, because Botanical Sanctum also isn't a combo with High Tide, so it's not that big of a deal. All right, I'm going to take the Steam Vents. We'll see how that works out. Oh, there's a Time Spiral. That's a whammy. That's a mise. That's just like one of the best cards we could have seen. Maybe the best realistically we could have seen. It actually might be better for this deck to see Time Spiral than to see like a random Mox. It's just so good with High Tide. Now I wish I had a Mystical Tutor. Boom. Hey, thanks for the raid, Court of Calls. I appreciate it. Welcome. I think this is closer to Constructed than Draft. So if you're used to watching Drafts, this is a little different. But there is Vamp, though. Vamp with Bayou and Misty and Mox Jet. I'm liking that. Yeah. Easy Vamp. Also, it means I can Spellseeker for Vamp. Oh, Preordain. Preordain makes the world go round. I think that is just great. So we're going to do that. Boom. And here we have Torrential Gearhulk, which is nice with Dig Through Time, Commit Memory, potentially Turnabout, Foff. We're actually four big spells plus Thirst, Brain Freeze, Vamp, High Tide. That's actually enough that I'm going to Gearhulk. I don't usually Gearhulk in these decks, but I think it's going to be fine. Oh, and there's a Time Twister. Sorry, LED. The draw sevens are just too important. All right. Well, we really made out like a bandit here. I'm going to take Dark Ritual. I don't think I'm playing it. That was nice. Hey, Bazil, welcome back to the 3-month resub. The only thing this deck's missing is another way to untap lands. Right now, I just have Turnabout and Time Spiral, and if I had Frantic Search, I'd have all of them. So that's really kind of what I deserve. I have Rotisserie Drafted Cube, indeed. I have not bought any books recently. I know there's a bunch of books I want to read. I just haven't quite got there. So someone asked, do you think the Mox showed that doing limited as part of an online effect isn't as hard as people think? Well, it was never the difficulty it was of doing it. It was more, do the viewers want to see it? And the answer still is medium. I loved it, but yeah. So now do we want time? Like, Mind's Desire is interesting. Seething Song, I don't think we're going to, after all this, I don't think we're actually in the Seething Song, the market for Seething Song. I can just stick Botanical Sanctum. This isn't really looking like a Mind's Desire deck. This deck's not going to play that many spells in the same turn. On the other hand, it's got a lot of good hits for Mind's Desire, but I think I'd rather just take another Fixer, especially now that I'm trying to play three colors here. I think I'm going to play the Hissing Quagmire either. Tilt City Diders, you drafted it. Pick one Strip Mine, pick two Mana Crypt and Crucible. Yeah, I would just take the Mana Crypt. I don't think that's close. If you really wanted to play the Crucible, that's like one thing. But all right, well, I guess no one's twinning on this in this particular draft. Hey, welcome back, Court of Calls. Yeah, you can. This cube has gotten easier to draft once the art became legible. For sure. Yes, it's weird, Squirrel, that Storm got more consistent when some of the changes I suggested went through. Ooh, I'll take a Kozilek. One less Kozilek to stop my brain freeze. And last pick, Turn Timber Symbiosis. I actually think I'll play that in this deck. Sometimes I'll just want to Turn Timber into like a Gearhulk or something. Nah, I mean, it's a shame Crucible didn't wheel there, but then, you know, what are you going to do? Like, so here, yeah, I kind of wish I had a Mind's Desire just because I have so many like thick cards to hit. But if I don't draw Lotus Bloom, Desire is not going to be the easiest thing to manage. All right, so this is with 16 lands plus a Bloom. Let's see. What do we want? Oh, that's with a Turn Timber Symbiosis. Okay. My sort by mana cost deck is wild, so let's see. This doesn't look too bad. Oh man, Mystic Sanctuary. I think Mystic Sanctuary would be kind of interesting, Justin. That would be not bad. Alright, so I didn't get the fast mana, so I don't really want Gush. Not really a Show and Tell. Show and Tell and a Shark Typhoon, huh? Is Witness a stretch? Well, here's the thing, is I think Socorro Tribe Elder is incredible in decks like this. And I've got Botanical Sanctum and Misty. So it's not going to be that hard to play green. Plus Heartbeat of Spring is pretty good because it's just a backup High Tide. And I think that's important. So yeah, it's worth playing green in this deck. And I think it's worth playing the Vamp as well. So we have one black card, three green cards. They all splash for Sakura Tribe Elder, but that I think is fine. Because what we'll end up doing is having a mana base. Let's see, I'm not going to add any. I don't think I even have a swamp. I think I just end up with three black sources, and I think that's plenty. And then we end up with, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 7 green, which is not unreasonable. And then, oh, we even can do 8 green. And that still ends up with 8, 9, 10 blue plus Sakura Tribe Elder. Hey, Not Punished. 55 months. Welcome back, Not Punished. Gush is not good. I would not recommend running Gush. You just don't want to. You're not going to want to return cards to the lands to your hand until literally the turn you kill them. So I think it's just not going to be enough. Well, it's really 10 islands, or 9 islands plus Sakura Tribe Elder. I think I'm going to do one fewer forest, one more island. All right, we'll do this. Oh yeah, Thassa's Oracle is going to go off. That's definitely true. Gush sucks. You just shouldn't play Gush. Like, you should play it if you have Fast Bond or if your deck is like a really low curve Storm deck, but the untapped land Storm deck really does not want Gush. Red Mage 5, welcome back. The 5 month resub, look at that, perfect. Oath Thassa does not work. That is not a combo. Just think it through. I won't explain it. I'll give everyone a chance to think it through and then they can come back and tell me why that's not a combo. All right. ASR 833 with 8 month resub. Welcome back. So here, I'm gonna lead on just Island Go. The question is, do I play a Thassa's Oracle on turn two or not? I do have ways to return it to my hand. I think I'm inclined because, well, we'll see what my opponent does. They mold the sixth because. I was kind of thinking of just casting a turn three time twister, you know, when they have two lands in play and I have three lands in play. But we'll see what they do. If they have a fast start, it's a little less enticing to do that. I think Echo Vians would be an interesting addition, but in general seems worse than Time Twister. So this would be where I'd want to draw Riftwing Cloudskate. That would be great. Or maybe a Lotus Bloom, something like that. Hey, Thalo, welcome. With a bunch of folks. Let's just go Botanical Sanctum and let's just play the Thassa's Oracle. The thing about Thassa's Oracle, too, is I have ways to bounce it, so having it in play is just not a big deal. Okay, I'll put a High Tide on top. And then, so now what I'm going to do, this is going to be great. I'm going to go, oh, I don't have an actual Trop. Damn, I wanted to Eternal Witness back my fetch to get more islands in play. I think I'm going to chill. All right, so I like that we're playing a green ramp more than blue-white. And that's what it looks like we are. Suspended a search for tomorrow. Interesting. That makes this Time Twister plan a lot less enticing. So I think I'm just going to chill here. And my plan is to, if I draw an island, next turn I can cast Botanical Sanctum off of... Or High Tide off Botanical Sanctum, and then Time Spiral off those islands. We'll see. If they play Glenalindra, it's just going to be tilting. Okay. There's a lot of cards that kill me from here. Lim King, why do you think I care that I have more viewers than Ben S, and why is that a relevant fact to bring up? It's just not, like, I have more viewers than a lot of people, and I have less viewers than a lot of people. Woo! I don't know. I just don't like... It's kind of like when coverage people are like, Cedric and PCL are the best combination by far. They're better than everyone else. And that's fine if you think that. Oh, okay. That's going to not hurt me that much, actually. But, like, why does everyone like... Like, well, why does it have to be that way? It's fine to be that way. I understand wanting to argue who's the best or whatever, but it's just like, why couldn't you just say, I like Cedric and PCL, you know? But, I don't know. It's just... The whole thing I find kind of weird. All right, well, that really wasn't that bad for me. They just killed a bunch of their own lands. Oh, if they're channeling something else out. Oh, man, they had channel top. They definitely wanted to channel and look with top. Wait, they're going to tinker now? Okay. I mean, I don't like this. Inkwell. You know what? I don't know that I'm dead yet. We'll see. I'm probably going to need something. Okay, that's not bad. So this is kind of a beat that I do have to get. I have to play that forest here, but let's just do this. Let's just chill. Our opponent's plays were getting close to the rim, but they're not quite above the rim. For a turn where they channeled, played an 8-drop, and then tinkered, I actually think I'm doing okay. That's true, BK. Usually I'm not the one asking, why's it got to be like this? They have one card in hand. So if they... kind of assuming they have no more plays this game that are mega relevant, I can block here, go to 12. Next turn, block, go to 5. And then I don't even have to do anything. Well, we'll see where we end up. I guess I'm kind of assuming that they're not going to play anything else here, but maybe they will. We'll see. I do speak Spanish. I have played Magic in Spanish. It's pretty difficult because Magic players use a lot of Spanish words that are like lingo. They got back Tinker. So, that's awkward for me. Hey, KFS, welcome back to the 21-month resub. Because if they Tinker sacking Sundering Titan, I lose two of my lands. What do I want to do here? I think, so I could commit to memory their Wall of Roots so they can't cast Tinker. I think if they have Tinker though, they're going to attack with the Sundering Titan first. No, actually, they have exactly Tinker in hand. I think I just put it back now. I don't think there's a reason to wait. No, Awesome Max, that's quite a bad play. The problem is, if I commit the Tinker, they lose the Titan. That's the problem. They kill my lands, then I just lose to Inkwell. No lands, please. Okay. It's not a land yet. Crazy Pyro, welcome back to the 18-month resub. Now, can I just draw a basic land of any kind? Preferably an island? No! They had the land! Ugh! After all that, they had to draw the land. Yeah, well, I guess I get to see what their third string Tinker target is. Yeah, sure. Well, I wasn't going to get there anyway. I was going to draw Sakura Tribe Elder. All right, well, that was a beat. Yeah, Kaldred, it is undies. That's why that's the problem. Oh, you're saying, I see what you're saying. Yes, it would be bad to put it back either way. Yeah, I mean, whatever. J12601, welcome back. 32 months. We're trying. We got channeled, tinkered. Like, we were, I think, fairly close to beating channel tinker, but we didn't quite get there. I could put in a nature's claim here. I don't know that would be good. Not worth Os Kozilek. Nope. No, that'd be not a good plan. No, the Titan is a leaves play trigger. So I could commit the Titan, I just would lose. Yeah, we could have just put in the slime ball if I wanted to. I just don't think that would be good. The problem is, I'm still just not going to beat a long interactive game, I don't think, by putting in cards like Acidic Slime and Nature's Claim. Can't you blow up Portal with Claim and they don't get their hand back? You really do not know what Course of Portal is. I forgot that this is kind of the first big Q stream I had where I can actually talk to chat. I forgot how little people know what the cards actually do and how little that stops them from making suggestions. I love it. I really do. What's up, Kronos? Welcome back. 71-month resub. hope things are going well. It's just, I wish I had the confidence of Twitch chat to suggest lines of play when they just don't know what any of the cards do. It's just impressive to me. I could Time Twister here. Hmm. This is interesting. No. That can't be the right play. I have the play. My play is, hey, what's up, Workshop? Welcome back. My play is sack Elder for Island, then Vamp for another Island, and then just Bribery them on turn three. That's going to be my play. Well, if they counter Bribery, I have backup here. But, yeah, this is going to be it. I can't even do better than Island, can I? That's really funny. We'll see what they got. Show me what you got. They're deciding whether to concede. I guess that's what Bribery does too. Drawing that Mox was pretty nice. Bum, bum, bum. All right, I'll take it. That's the cost of, this is why actually we removed Bribery from our Vintage Cube, the one Gabby has, because it just punishes people for putting gigantic creatures in their deck, which I don't think is like the most fun thing in the world. But you know, what can you do? The Mox was a lot of fun, Popohod. I was like, casting the Mox, I got to do Vintage Cube Browns and then just watch the rest, basically. It made me want to play a high stakes Vintage Cube, and it made me want to do commentary and more Vintage Cubes. It just made me want more Vintage Cubes. It was great. Ed, White Aggro is very good in Cube. It's one of the best decks. I think Mono Red is the best deck, but I think White Aggro might be number two in terms of just straight up like win percentage, you know, what you're looking for. Yeah, this hand's fine. So what this hand is going to end up doing is playing Tribe Elder on turn two, and then turn three Spellseeking for Vamp and probably casting a Time Twister. Uh-oh. That could be dangerous. Interesting. Rift Reno. I don't know what your list you're talking about, Astrobaya. Oh, the cube list? Yes, that's on Cube Tutor. You can go to Cube Tutor, search for Gabby Sparks there. So, I don't like my position here. The question is it better to... Let's see, if I go turn two Tribe Elder, I don't like removing Emrakul. I think Emrakul is interesting. It's a good card in the cube. There's an argument for removing Channel. I can buy that. But I think Emrakul making Sneak and Breach good is actually strong. So if I go Tribe Elder, yeah, I actually think this is going to end up being the strongest play. Because what I'm going to do, I'm actually just going to do the same play again. I'm just going to go Tribe Elder and then turn three, play Spellseeker for Vamp and then pass and then Vamp for a Bribery. I mean, yeah, my opponent might just do something busted here, but if they do, they do. You know, I can't do anything about that. And I'm actually just going to get Islands here. Because, first of all, this deck wants more Islands in play. And second, oh. Second, I want to make it Sundering Titan less impactful on me. So now, actually, I still think I just get Vamp. Because what I want to do will depend maybe on what they do here. Daluke, welcome back to the 23-month Resubarino. Bum, 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 bum. Yeah, I think that green having channel is like as its way to do kind of BS stuff is fine. I think channel, at least you have to do work. Bribery is like, again, I'm fine playing it. I don't think it's like an egregious crime. I do think it just makes the cube games a little less interesting and punishes kind of the wrong thing, you know? Like a card that punishes creatureless decks is a very different thing than a card that punishes decks that put cool creatures in their deck. Well, the cool thing here is I could also potentially vamp for Moxjet if we end up in a situation where they blow up one of my lands or something. So they could cast Sundering Titan. It would kill my Bayou and my Island and then their Hallowed Fountain. That'd be pretty good. So I hope they don't do that. Turn 4 Sundering Titan. I mean, Basalt Monolith is good if you mox it out on turn 2 and then play a big thing on turn 3. In general, I don't think it's very good. Oh, they have Tinker? Is that the joke here? Oh, they have the Tomb. Who knows? Oh man, Yosemite, that was an old deck. I love that deck. Gifts Rock was a lot of fun. Fractured Identity, my Spellseeker. Okay, I didn't put that on my list of things that were likely to happen, but I'm kind of into it. So, We'll see what they get. This is where I wish I just had Force of Will. If I just was able to vamp for a Force of Will here, it'd be really good. I mean, Fracture Identity on whatever I bribed for could have been worse, but I guess if I got Inkwell, it'd be pretty bad. Well, this can get Channel. So maybe they do expect that. but my plan is to bribery them and hope to get Sundering Titan, kill three of their lands, and make it so they can't do much. They could not get Tinker off of this. This does not get Tinker. Also, they had to tap it that way anyway. Mm-hmm. Lilting Lola, welcome back. 5 months. So the thing is, oh wait, they have to have Sundering Titan in their deck. If they had Sundering Titan, they would have cast it. So we're going to get to bribe for Sundering Titan. Oh, they got an Ancestral Recall. Fancy. Yeah, their deck has a lot of cool stuff in it. I think I'm still in a pretty good shape here. So I'm not even sure if I vamp. So if I vamp, what am I even vamping for? Like, I feel like it's almost better if I wait to see what my natural draw is, because if I vamp, I guess I could vamp for Time Warp. So if I vamp, the thing is I could just do it next turn. I think I'm just going to wait. And here's the reason. That's funny. Is if I drew a High Tide or a Time Spiral, I could vamp for like the other half of that piece. Okay, so they have Sundering Titan and Inkwell in their hand, Tinker in their deck, as we knew. Channel, Nature's Claim, Oko. Wow, their deck is good. But yeah, I'm going to get Sundering Titan. It's going to be pretty good here. Oh, I guess I have to lose my Black Source. Yeah, no, never mind. I should have vamped. I still don't know what I would have vamped for, though. Yeah. I should have vamped maybe for High Tide. I don't know. I'm going to get to Riftwind next turn. It's going to be pretty good. Well, I guess I could have just vamped for High Tide because I have Dig Through Time and I can find other stuff. I should have vamped. It would have been better. Suspect Agent, welcome back. 53 months. Can't I just bribery again next turn? If I had another mana, then the answer would still be no, because this doesn't cast sorceries. I'm probably going to end up... I might actually just Riftwing their Spellseeker and then whack them for 7 down to 9, and then I have Lethal in play. That seems probably fine. They don't have a blue source for Ancestral, which is going to put them in a pretty precarious position here. Yeah, this vamp should probably be a High Tide in my hand. Hey, the very lone wolf. Welcome back, the 6 month resub. From what I see. Okay, well, we got ourselves a game here. From what I saw, as Lubar is the basalt monolith, not keeping them off of anything too interesting. I think I'm just gonna pass and just cast Dig Through Time for the full amount. Riftwing's awesome. No, Riftwing's better than you think, Cunning Walrus. I know that I like it more than I should, but Riftwing is... let's just dig in response. It's not really going to change too much what I get. Though I guess I know they don't even have counters, so whatever. So here, I have another island to hit. I definitely want Commit Memory. The question is, do I want Turnabout or a Basic Forest? What am I doing next turn? I'm probably casting Riftwing next turn. Oko's annoying, sure. It's not that big of a deal, though. What am I doing next turn? Because if I'm not hard casting Riftwing, I could see getting Thirst next turn. And then keeping up... I kind of want to cast this Gearhulk at some point, too. Why don't I just get land... I'm just gonna get land. I don't really have very many green cards left. I just have Heartbeat of Spring. I just got Commit and land. I assume they're not gonna do anything else here, and then I'm gonna Riftwing their island. I think, or maybe not. Maybe I should have gotten Thirst. No, Kronos. I'm fairly anti-library as far as these things go. I'm at 16. Actually, you know what? I'm just going to do this, because the reason I want to do this is this keeps them from playing Teferi. They could still Tinker for Inkwell, but I think I can outrace a Tinker for Inkwell given my hand. So if that's what their next turn's play is, I just don't mind that much. And then next turn I can Torrential Gearhulk Dig would be my weapon of choice. Okay. Oh, Azorius Signet. That's a good one. Azorius Signet is pretty strong because it gets them out of the mana lock they were in. And Oko. Okay. Sure. So now they're going to make a food probably. I think what's going to be pretty cool is I get to then just pass with Commit and Gearhulk up and then just use my mana end of their turn. Maybe threaten Oko. Who knows? Angry Bob, yeah, this is likely going up on YouTube as well. I'm just going to play my island. I don't really want to shuffle because the bottom of my deck sucks. I'll attack Oko. So my Bayou's gone, so I don't get black off that. Having a High Tide instead of a Vamp would have been a lot better because I probably would have gotten to combo off. Let me see. I would have snagged Turnabout Commit Memory off the thing. Yeah, I don't even know if I would have gone for it, though, because I don't have the Time Spiral or anything. I'm probably going to be able to go off next turn as well. Just end of turn Gearhulk into Dig, and I know my bottom, like, six cards or whatever. And then if I find High Tide Time Spiral, it's just going to be pretty sweet there. Well... Oko is very good in cube. It's probably a bit too good. So the question here, well, I guess if they tap out first, it becomes less interesting. I was going to wonder if I should play Gearhulk to block and just eat the food. Okay. Oko is very good. I think it's fine to include it in vintage cube. I don't think it's like unreasonable not to, but I think including it is okay. Yeah, I'm going to eat the food. Time to eat the food, Zlubars. Like, if you're taking Oko out because of power level, it's a little weird. Like, I would accept taking Oko out because you don't enjoy it. I think the first precept for cube is, like, play cards, put cards in you enjoy, don't put cards in you don't enjoy. But keep in mind that it's not just you, it's everyone's experiences. So, like, I do think it's worth... And then Regrowth Fractured Identity? That what's happening? Yeah, sure. But I think that Oko is a card I would generally just attacking with that. Okay, well I'm still just gonna eat it. So I don't know. I mean I think it's fine to cut Oko if you don't enjoy the Oko experience, which is totally reasonable. I think on power level it's fine for it to stay in. There's the Time Spiral. I don't have the High Tide. There's also an Archmage, so I think I'm going to do is I'm going to get Time Spiral and Archmage, and if I draw High Tide, then I get to do some High Tide stuff, and if I don't, I might just... Oh, and I guess Glenn doesn't actually do what I want to. Boom. Hey, thanks for the raid, Ben. Welcome. We're playing the as Ben would agree, the highest form of limited cube. We're about to cast a Time Spiral, probably. Because their hand is Fracture Identity. I guess I can buy an extra turn by committing Fracture Identity. Also, what happens if I play Archmage? They Elk it, and then they can Fracture Identity my... Oh, Archmage or... Yeah, that's probably not good. So the question now is, I definitely don't want to crack a fetch. Just play an island. I think I just play an island and a Marshall Raid. What up, everybody? I am drafting Storm. I'm deciding how to storm off as well. They have Channel, but that doesn't change them. They have to have a green source. No, that doesn't really change much. I think buying an extra draw step is fine here. Like, they can Elk my Torrential Gearhulk, and then that's fine too. Misty cannot get black. My Bayou's already exiled. Hope you drafted some sweet decks, Marshall. Okay, we're going to commit to memory this thing. Plus, I mean, them Fracture identitying my Gear Hulk, like, it would be bad for me, but it's not even going to change that much in terms of my going off, right? They would Gear Hulk and Ancestral be mostly tapped out, and then next turn I'd probably Time Spiral. I still think it's obviously fine to do this, but, and then now they're going to Elk my Gear Hulk. It just gives me an extra draw step for High Tide, and I know my bottom 12 cards, so I'm at 1 and 7 to hit High Tide. Yeah, Marshall's watch repair videos are awesome. I don't know if it's going to be that. First of all, Marshall, this deck's pretty good. I wouldn't anticipate a clean 3-0 from it, though. We'll see. What were the two decks you drafted, Marshall? Already sweet. All right, yeah, Elk that. And now they could channel, but that doesn't change all that much. The Raiders beat Denver. That's funny. The now Vegas Raiders. Works for me. Okay, so they're going to witness back something. The witness protection program. I might be able to eventually kill their Oko with Rift. No, that can never happen. This deck could definitely struggle against Mono Red. If you look at my sideboard, though, I do have a Thragtusk. So that's kind of game. What up, Sponzy? 61 month resub. Remember when Oakland had sports teams? Yeah, but neither of us really cared, so... whatever. Basically, I like when they're sports teams that are a good deal, and I like dislike when they're not. And I know some of them can be really bad deals. I don't think they have enough green mana for that, for witness back Nature's Claim. I've been to some A's games. I think I've been to all the Oakland sports teams games. Like, I've been to Raiders games, I think twice. I've been to a bunch of A's games, and I've been to 2 Warriors games. Well, I've been to 2 Warriors games when they were good, and then I think probably 1 or 2 when they weren't. All right, they're getting back Nature's Claim, and that's fine with me. I never met the Lonely Island guys, no. Can I explain why Glenn is so powerful in Cube? Non-creature spells are really strong. This counters 2 of them. It's really hard to kill. It can even block well. It's got a lot of synergies. Just a really good card. Hey, lady, 49 months. All right, lady, gonna give me a High Tide here? Is that what you're going to do? Hoya. No, but that was probably about as good. Wow. Okay, so now I actually get to kill Oko, first of all. They're going to double block, but I can't do anything about that. Yeah, I'm going to attack them because there's a slightly less chance they block. They didn't double block. That is perfect. That is perfection. Lady, I appreciate the help. I'm just going to play this tapped because I'll probably play that next turn. The genital shows up. All right. They have a Nature's Claim in their hand. They have a Fracture Identity 2 down. Honestly, it doesn't seem like it's right to play Time Spiral as much as everyone wants, but here's the thing. Marshall just threw down the gauntlet. He challenged me to, you know, he said he'd got some nice 3-0 6-0s. So given that, I'm going to go for the victory here, and I believe this is my highest chance because now I also get to have Glenn up and then vamp end of turn. So, like, what can they do? What can they do? Like, there's just such a limited number of cards that get them out of this. So what kind of cards are you looking to first pick after Power for aggro, you ask, Sir Matthew? Depends which aggro decks, but Strip Mine is a really high pick. For the white decks, Thalia is probably your overall best card, followed by like Vryn Wingmare and Geddens. One drops in particular really good for Mono Red. Just Jake, I couldn't vamp for that because I didn't have black mana. The Misty does not get black mana. Vortex, no, the good Thalia, the 2-mana Thalia. Skyclave Apparition is pretty strong, yeah, I like that one. One drops in red, so the one drop creatures and the cheap burn spells. And then the expensive stuff for both red and white aren't that important, with the exception of Armageddon, which is the whites, one of their best ways to win against unfair decks. I haven't been cubing that much this time around. It just been busy. Not GTA. GTA is not a high pick for any deck. Do not high pick Jita. You will not like the results. Is Hellrider important? No. And there's no 4-mana card for the mono red deck that I'm going to tell you is important because they're all less of a priority than the cheaper cards. That said, you do want cards like Hellrider and Koth in your red deck, but you just shouldn't be taking them early because they're very replaceable. Grimmar, I've got a bunch of vids queued up. They just haven't gone up yet. So I'm gonna put some of those up. Yeah, I like this hand. This hand's a little slow. This hand needs to clear Tribelder so badly. If I can preordain into Tribelder, then I'm liking what I got going on here. Though Mox Jet would also be okay, but Tribelder is really what I want. When it's playing Island and they mulligan to six here. I don't think I want either of those cards. They don't do much for me. I have been consuming a lot of cube content because BK's been cubing. That's been fun. Let's just play. In general, you should lean towards playing the basics over non-basics because of Wasteland here. It always feels so slow to do just have no play till turn three. Okay, they don't have anything either. The Cloudscape would have been really good earlier. I'm just going to Spellseeker here, I think. Don't really care if they counter it too much. So they have what looks like a pretty solid Jeskai deck there. We'll see what they come up with next turn. I really hope I draw land. It looks like I could be playing against a twin deck. I don't really know. I don't know what's going on. I guess they ooh, Emery. Oh, nice. Their deck's looking a little spicy there. Okay, let's just Spellseek again here. And the funny thing is I actually still think I get High Tide even though I have one island in play. Yeah. Well, see what's up, my name's Josh. Seeing Remand, Arid Mesa, Sacred Foundry already looks like your deck is good. Oh wow, getting to time to Treasure Cruise here off your Emery. That's a good little usage of cards. Oh, they're tapping out for something. Maybe they might not be a twin deck. Twin is part of the reason the twin style decks are so good. Well, maybe they are. Is the ones that have a lot of cheap counters like the Mana Leak, Remand, Force of Will twin decks are just so hard for every deck to basically fast combo with counter magic is really tough. They got a Thassa's Oracle. What you got going on over there, buddy? All right, Island. Basic Island. Not too much to ask, right? Basic Island? Because if I did that, I could just Time Warp and then set up a Spiral High Tide plan. I think I'm just suspending Skate and passing the turn. I don't think tapping out for Glenn is going to do much for me. That was my opportunity. Oh yeah, I'm going to vamp for a basic island again. That is going to happen. Is really Thassa's Oracle the best thing you can get right now? What's going on? Oh man, they're not even spinning top before playing Abbott, and they're tapping their land. Not good. Not good sequencing there, my friend. All right. I guess I probably shouldn't brain freeze them in response. Also, they've kind of cast a lot of cards. They only have 18 cards in their deck. Alright. I don't mind drawing Spellseeker again, I don't think. I'm like very close to just brain freezing them, which is funny. So do I have a way to no, I'm just gonna get Island. I was just wondering if I had a way to maybe brain freeze them in some way, but I don't. Alright. And then I'll time warp to try to play the world's slowest explorer. If I draw oh, they forced my Time Warp? Okay, well, that's fine. It could have gone a lot worse for me. I mean, I don't know if they're going to, like, kill me or something now. But that could have been way worse for me. Am I playing enough islands? I believe I am playing enough islands, yeah. I've drawn mo a lot of my non-island lands so far. Okay. That's gonna be tough. That one's not gonna be easy to beat. Oh, I've got the Riftwing. Never mind. Never mind, chat. Riftwing Cloudskate saves the day once again. I'm just gonna play Glen. I'm gonna be able to protect myself from them doing anything, and then next turn the Riftwing's gonna pop on in, and that's just gonna be game. Wow, Riftwing Cloudskate, what can't it do? Just amazing. Truly incredible. Oh, tapping top to draw. So Zealous Conscripts doesn't kill me. Goblin Welder could not care less about. It's also keeping back a bunch of their powerful squad here. I'll block here. Why not? Oh, look at this. Look at this. It's a creature, so you can't counter it. Gets the Glenelg off the board. They have one card in hand, and I have Glen. If I draw an island here, then we're just in great shape. But I think we're actually fine either way. That's just getting greedy wanting to draw that island. All right, blue. Just gonna go for high tide. And I mean, I can literally get close to brain freezing them, but I don't think I don't want to do that. I mean, they're gonna have a lot of lands in play and a bunch of counter magic, but I actually have the Glen. Me having Glen here is pretty critical. Okay, let's start with a Preordain, I think. I'm doing great, is how I'm doing. All right, draw. Bribery, huh? Let's go Thirst. I actually am probably gonna want to, almost assuredly gonna want to discard two cards here. I hope they don't have Brain Freeze. Well, okay. So here's the thing. If they Brain Freeze me, this is the last card draw I'm gonna put on the stack, I think. I get to counter two Brain Freeze copies, so that's good. So right now it's not even lethal. So we're far from lethal. If they have a spell into Brain Freeze, it could be bad though. What is this? I mean, I have a Glen in play, so I don't know about tapping 10 mana for something. We'll see. I think. Oh, I could also counter my own Thirst. This is also true. I think Lotus Bloom in a Storm deck is fine. It's not going to be one of your best cards or anything, but it can definitely. I mean, I'm playing it here. Definitely has some good effects. I'm really confused as to what. Is this like an expansion explosion? I don't even know. Okay, so two cards. I'm going to discard those two. All right. Let's tap this for black. Blue, 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 blue. And then turn about. Actually, I'm gonna green. Play a Mox. I don't even need to tap the Mox, actually. I just have it there. And I'll turn about using my blue. Untap my lands. So I've played a lot of Storm Mirrors. And one thing, now that that Thirst is gone, I'm not gonna cycle Shark Typhoon. I'm not, like, I can cast Dig Through Time. Because it doesn't matter if they Brain Freeze me in response to Dig in the terms of me having no cards in my deck. I am a little worried. I think I want to cast. Do I cast Bribery? Do I cast Dig first? Nah, we don't need to shark here. I don't think. Sure. I'm just trying to figure out how I can not get Brain Freezed out. Maybe I actually. No, I should have. I actually think I should have probably dug earlier. Because now, if they Brain Freeze me, I'm not going to have any cards left. Okay, whew. I just need to find Brain Freeze is one for sure, and then I don't no. Oh, Turn Timber Symbiosis actually is number two. Yeah, because I could hit Thassa's Oracle with Turn Timber Symbiosis probably. So let's go now. Now we just bribery, and now we bribery them to get the Eldrazi out of their deck before we Brain Freeze them. What is in their deck? Their deck has Force of Negation and Force of Will, Glen, Imperial Recruiter, Trinket Mage, Brainstorm. All right. And then now we can brain freeze them for millions. Oh yeah. We are going deep here, Marshall. Don't worry. This I'm just trying to cover my bases here. Now I have two Glennonolds. I just have to remember not to sack theirs. The shields are very much up, though. All right, are you going to finally cast this, like, 10-mana spell that you've been wanting to cast the whole time? X equals 7. And they have Force of Will and Force of Negation? Okay. they can draw a bunch of cards if they want. And there we go. I did really want to end up in a spot where I had to turn Timber Symbiosis into Thassa's Oracle to win, though. That I was hoping for. Nature's Claim... Their welder stuff doesn't seem that good. I didn't see a big welder thing. I guess I don't... They have like six cards in their hand I don't know or something. They didn't have a Brain Freeze, otherwise I would board in my own Kozilek. No, Bribery is probably going to be fine against them. It's going to be hard to beat Glenalendra, but I do have Riftwing, I guess. Mm-hmm. If they drew Fire Blast, it wouldn't do much. Oh, they have a twin. They did have twin, didn't they? All right. Well, maybe if we go to game three, I can get that in. Yeah, I'm gonna keep. It's gonna be hard for me to want to mulligan a hand with a Brain Freeze and a High Tide in it. Vraska may be good. I don't... Oh, actually... I think I'm just going to play this. Because I don't think it's... I'm not going to be turn four High Tiding. And I think just playing this and not paying the life is probably for the best. Especially if they're trying to get me with a Monastery Swift Spear, apparently. So... I don't know that I'm going to do this, but I could Brain Freeze myself for six... And so I can witness it back. Seasoned Pyromancer, okay. I kind of want to play Witness this turn, so I think I am going to Brain Freeze myself. And then look for Time Spiral. I didn't hit Time Spiral, that is a shame. I am going to play Witness, and I think I just get Dig Through Time here. And then go for a slightly slower maneuver. Yeah, Zach, I wasn't talking about turn Timber Symbiosis to stop Brain Freeze. I was more saying, in general, it would be cool to, if this deck ends up winning by using turn Timber Symbiosis in order to find Thassa's Oracle. Is top the most dreaded turn one play? No. They boarded into Beatdown? They're attacking me for two? They're leaving back the tokens? I guess I'll block. I think that's fine. Oh. Okay, there's a pretty good chance. What did they get? They got an Earthshaker that I should be able to win next turn here. Because I'm going to get to cast a Dig Through Time this turn. And then with High Tide and Heartbeat in hand already, that should be pretty... Oh, they have Force of Will and Force of Negation in their deck. That is kind of a problem. Okay. Yeah, they found their land. And they're playing an Everflowing Chalice for one. Okay. Are they going to play an Earthshaker Kenra now? So they have three cards in hand. I guess I just hope. Well, you know what? I hope they don't have Force of Will or Force of Negation. There's some chance they would have Force of Will to Dig Through Time, but they can't even Force of Negation it. They can't even make that effect. All right. I could also cycle a Shark Typhoon for two, eat one of those, take six. Nah. Let's just do this. All right, so I'm going to cast Dig. I think I actually pay the mana because I kind of want some of these cards left in my deck. I don't, for if I shuffle. Not a witness as much, though. Hey, Coriander, welcome back with the 3-month Resubarino. Okay. So we got some stuff here. Interesting. So what am I trying to do here? Next turn I'll have 5 mana. I can't quite Heartbeat and Time Warp. Yeah, no, Turnabout's probably going to be good. The question is Commit Memory good? So, let's say if I take Turnabout and Commit Memory, and I go Island, High Tide, cast Heartbeat, cast Turnabout, and then I'll have access to 9, 13 mana, so I could cast Commit and have 3 floating. That's with committing to memory and drawing 7. I mean, I'm definitely going to take Turnabout. The question is, do I want to take a Time Warp or something instead? But oh, we're not beating Force. I'm not worried about that. That no longer is something that it concerns me. Like, if we get forced, we get forced. The problem is 3 mana floating is just not enough. I think I'm gonna wait a turn. Waiting a turn adds so much mana. So I'm gonna play Riftwing and I'm gonna bounce an elemental and pass the turn here. And then I can block something, and I'm not even taking that much damage here. I just don't think I'm that likely to beat a Force. Okay. Well, no, I'm definitely gonna take that. That's unfortunate. That's a card I will have a hard time beating, but not impossible. I think I'm going to do here. We'll see what they tap down to. I'm probably going to end up cycling a Shark Typhoon at some point here. Dimir Signet, sure. Like, they're not going to attack with the Glen, right? If they... Oh, they do? That's really good for me. So now I'm just going to cycle this to make a 4-4. Their sideboard plan was good. I actually think I'm going to be able to grind them out here, though. I'm taking 2 going down to 7. Glenn comes back with 1 counter. And then, I mean, obviously if they have some burn, they could just kill me here. But next turn, I'm going to be able to play Tribuilder and then end of turn commit their Glenn. I could try to cast High Tide, and if they can't... Oh, hold on. What if I do that? Again, not playing around Force, but let's say if I just cast High Tide, if they let High Tide happen, then I get to kind of do all the other stuff, right? It doesn't really... So if I cast High Tide, if they counter it, I can cast Heartbeat and then Turnabout and then Time Twister. Yeah, I actually think that's fine. If they have a counter in their hand as well as the Glen, then... You know, that's, again, unfortunate, but... Okay, so they're going to Glen. Then I'm going to cast Heartbeat of Spring. Oh, they had... Okay. I guess I tapped wrong given that, but this is fine. I'm not dead. Okay. I mean, I have a 4-4 Shark. There's obviously things that are bad for me here. Are they going to twin their Kenra? That'd be funny. Oh, they're... Well, that's not really going to get me here. They should definitely attack with their Kenra. I think I just block with the Kenra, or block the Kenra to keep myself out of Fire Blast range. Draw, and then now... Like I said, if they have more counters, they have more counters. If they had a counter, they would have countered this, right? Because now I'm in a spot where, you know what, I don't need to get greedy. I kind of wanted to Sakura Tribuilder and get a land first. But yeah, I'm really glad I didn't if they're going to counter me here. Oh, they're cycling Miscalc. Okay. All right, land, untap. So now... I guess it's probably worth preordaining, because if I hit Time Spiral, it's much better. So bottom, top, and then because I hit Time Spiral, I get to Sakura Tribuilder as well. Oh, this is Blue-Green Storm. What? Oh. So they did have the brain freeze. Okay. Well, they probably wanted to cast that in response to a card draw if something was happening, but that this is fine. I'm going to get brain freeze into zero cards. Oh, if my sound is too loud, I could board myself, or I could just turn it. I turned it down a little bit there. I guess I don't have any things left to get, so I don't really care about casting commit, I don't think. So I think I'm just going to do this. Okay, I'll turn it back up a little. There. Okay. We... Actually, hold on. Okay. That is a high tide. It's high tide. And then we still have this commit memory here. So they have to draw all of their, like... Oh, man. Maybe... I was just going to say, maybe I shouldn't actually... Yeah, I actually shouldn't... Well, so I'm in a weird spot where I cast the Preordain not really thinking about it, but they actually could have brain freeze me to death in response. So that wasn't a good idea. I'm not going to bet on them not having it. I think they're brainstorming. I think I let that happen because if they find the brain freeze here, then it's actually great for me because then I just play the Thassa's Oracle. Okay, so I have a lot of mana. So let's go. So what I'm actually gonna do here is I'm gonna Gear Hulk my High Tide, and the reason is I guess I could have committed my Preordain, yes. The reason I wanna do that is I wanna pass with mana floating. Oh, sure, that doesn't matter. So they can't have brain freeze mana anymore. Yeah, I'm in my first main, so let's just pass. Okay, I'm not gonna attack. Well, no, I'm not gonna attack. There was a chance that there was some like time twister win there, but all right, island, and then I think I actually suspend a Cloud Skate. Definitely don't play Thassa's Oracle here. And then just cast Time Spiral. Alright. Or Time Twister, rather. Okay. I think I should be okay now. My island's tapped for just ridiculous amounts of mana. Because now I can play Glen. And then now... Because I keep shuffling their Force of Wills back, remember? Because they had two mana floating is why we went to our second main for this. That is a... It's actually... It actually matters quite a bit. And then let's just cast Thirst. And then I want to discard two cards. And then now... So let's see, I have six mana. Oh, I haven't played a land. Playing a land is good. Because now, I want to make sure at the end of this I can Time Warp. So I can still Time Warp even after casting Dig. Is that right? Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. No, I guess I actually guess I have to Time Warp first. Oh, they had the Force. Yeah, let's Glen the Force here. Because I don't think I'm going to win this turn. If they had literally Force and Force of Negation, it would have been bad for me, but luckily they did not. And then I'm just going to pass. I don't want to brain freeze them. I don't want to give them a chance to untap. I think I can beat them with just... I didn't even suspend that, whatever. I think I can beat them with Thassa's Oracle. It'd be pretty... It's actually impossible for me to miss Thassa's Oracle at this point. I just have to draw like a few more cards here. Thassa's Oracle. And I don't even actually need to draw more cards now that I think about it. Because now I've got the Glen still. Now I can spell Seeker for Brain Freeze and then Brain Freeze myself. Why not attack? Why attack? I don't want to waste my time and yours. I'll get brain freeze, and then I'll brain freeze myself. And then cast Thassa's Oracle, and whew, took a little work, but you know, we managed to get there. All right. Are we 2-0? I think we are. I think we're going for that trophy here. Oh, man, I love playing the Storm decks. They are a lot of fun. There's a lot of old wildness that goes down. Yeah, the match before not vamping was definitely a bad thing, and that almost cost us. But I liked generally how we played that. Jamie Paul, this isn't a great format for like, hey, what are your overall cube suggestions? But I think in general, finding good archetypes to support is going to be what's the most fun. I really like when Birthing Pod is supported, for example. I think that there's a lot of cool decks, or having black have a sacrifice theme is pretty fun as well. The one thing I would avoid putting too many planeswalkers in, because I think that some of the cubes tend to have a few too many of those. Yeah. I really have drawn all my islands, or all my non-islands, huh? Hey, Anti-Rush, welcome back. 1 month, Arisa Barino. Sir Matthew, I already explained why I didn't want to brain freeze them. I would not like to pay 3 life. Oh, no. Oh. Yeah. They get to take my dig, which is pretty annoying. That was my, like, big piece of action. I might end up spell seeking for, like, a preordain. We'll see. I'm not really playing that many colors. I'm playing a blue deck that's like 85% blue, has one black card and three green cards. But I guess my opening hand does look a little different than that. Hard to not break up the combo of Heartbeat Turnabout too for them. They might take Heartbeat, in which case I can Spellseeker for High Tide or something. Flex Retro, 59 months. Welcome back. You're air frying a corn dog right now? Nice. I like it. Okay, they took the Heartbeat. That's a good pick. I think that's a pretty smart choice. Oh, good. Another forest. yeah, these videos will go up on CFB's YouTube as well. Time to spell seek. I guess they knew about the Bayou. Foff is nice here because I can cast Foff pretty easily. I think here, I'm just going to get the High Tide. If I didn't draw the Foff, I might have gotten Preordained, but I think I'm just going to get the High Tide, because then next turn I can play land, pass with Foff, and then I would like to draw islands, hopefully. No, Lobster, you still got it wrong. If you brain freeze them, they don't just die. They have to draw a card. You'd have to pass. So unless I had a way to force them to draw a card, which I did not, then it would require passing. So the confusion continues, apparently. Yes, getting Breeding Poor Trop is really important for these decks, for sure. Oh, man. I guess I just passed. They don't know about the Foff. I don't know. I'm in a spicy mood. If chat wants to come with dumb suggestions, I'll respond in kind. So they can't quite flip Jace unless they have a cheap card, which they seem to. Liliana. Okay. Okay. I mean, now they can flip Jace, but they're tapped out. Okay, so I'm going to Foff, and if I draw an island, it's not awful, but yeah. I mean, we'll see if we'll see what we Foff into, I suppose. Set ourselves up for a long game here. I guess we're going to get Duress next turn off this Jace, which I think is kind of annoying. Yeah, I thought about it, but I thought there was a chance that, like, so the main reason, Andrew, I didn't is I thought there was a chance they'd flip Jace and duress me, and whether knowing, Okay, that's my first alarm. Just a reminder to Gabby's making soup, but I have to go do a little bit of the prep for it at the end, or like the last finishing touches. Anyway, sorry, Andrew. The reason I didn't want a main phase is knowing whether duress is on the stack or not will change my Foff selections quite a bit. Yeah, I'm really leaning towards the whatever pile has the island in it. It is smart to... Yeah, exactly, Eric. It is smart to split up island and Riftwing, but... Yeah, I'll probably take island commit and just commit the Jace. Yeah. All right, another island is solid, so let's just go commit on Jace. And I actually think I want to do it now, both so it resolves and I wouldn't mind them milling it with Liliana because it's just not that big of a deal. All right, pass. Is there anything I haven't done in Vintage Cube that I want to try? Nothing like specific, but there are decks that, I mean, I don't know. I like putting things together. I really like drafting the like land destruction type decks. Those decks are always really fun. I don't think there's a deck that I've like thought, oh man, I really want to do that and I haven't managed to. Okay. Oh yes. Scroll, the answer to that is yes. Okay, well, they really wanted their Jace back. That actually is fine with me. If that's the way the cookie's going to crumble. Yeah, that the Parallax Wave banishing light stuff, Matt, that's basically impossible, though. Okay. I'm going to get Duress next turn. I kind of think I just do some things here. Like, I've got a draw 7 at some point. I think I'm going to turn about myself... I don't have any way to pick up the Serpentine Wood, unfortunately. Untap. And so now I guess I kick things off with Dig. Well, hold on. Daggerhawk, welcome to the divination. What do I want to do? If I dig, I don't mind exiling 3 of those cards. It's probably better to dig than it is to draw 7 here. 3, 4. I can probably exile Heartbeat at this point, I think. I'll leave High Tide in the mix. Maybe I should have chumped a Spellseeker, actually. Oh, there's the Time Spiral. That's what we were looking for. All right. I have 8 mana, so I can't Time Spiral plus do anything else, unfortunately. We aren't that flush on mana. Hey, what up, Sneaky Fat Kid? Welcome back 2 years. Bam. Already played a land. I guess I'll take Bribery in case somehow this Time Spiral doesn't resolve. And then I need Bribery or whatever, but I don't think that's very likely to happen. Come on, Action. One cool thing about Dig in these decks, by the way, is it lets you exile cards from your graveyard that you don't want to draw post-spiraling, and that can be pretty nice. Okay, this is mediocre. I could just Time Twister right away, but I think it's better to let's see. If I Thirst, I'll have 8 mana left, which means if I draw High Tide or Time or Turnabout, it's pretty nice. Or Time Warp, yeah, that's probably enough to go for it. Yeah, I don't like seeing that. I think I'd rather just Twister here. I'm not loving that, but oh, I'm loving this. Now I'm loving this. All right, hold on. Let's hold control. Surely they don't need to counter my Thassa's Oracle. Oh, I have a response. Woo! Yeah, exactly. Suckers. I don't know that they even had a counter anyway, but... This is the plan. So now if they had one counter, they would still lose. In fact, I think 2 counters, they would still lose. That is great. Oh, also if they countered the Oracle, I would just storm them out. All right, playing against blue-black control. Yeah, we sure are. We sure are. Imagine if I start with Lotus Bloom in my opening hand. That would be some stuff. Oh, this is a nice little. This isn't the cleanest Storm deck, but it's very good. I think this deck has most of the pieces you're looking for. Do do do. Why is Turn Timber Symbiosis in there? Because I don't think it cost me that much to play it as a land. And later in the game, when you're doing the Time Spiral, Time Twister thing, Louis, and you end up with tons of mana, I think having this to hit a Oracle or a Gearhulk or something is decent. Yeah, it could definitely have a Reanimator aspect. Bayesian Magic, I like both those things. So welcome to the Divination. I don't actually know that this is good enough, but I'm kind of curious to like get a better sense of it, you know? Certainly, yeah, I know. This isn't a Thousand-Year Storm deck, unfortunately. No, the Soup Alarm wasn't to do it right now. It's to warn me that in half an hour there's another one coming. Hey, welcome back. Don't stop, Santa. 61 months. That's a lot of months of Santa not stopping. In fact, your time to shine is in about a month and a half here. Yeah, Parney, the forests are so I can draw more forests. and cast the Turn Timber Symbiosis with all those forests. I'm not like deep into Bayesian statistics, but I know enough about it to know that's a good way to approach a lot of probabilistic things. Mm-hmm. How deep? We're in the finals, up a game, no big deal. Well, part of the Soup Alarm is I have to put the Kale in between 6 and 6:30, so I kind of have some alarms set, because if I'm in the middle of something, maybe... Oh, there's the Bloom. The Bloom and Onion. I like this. This ant's really good. I might end up wanting to... I can sequence it so it makes the most sense with the stream here. I'm not making a soup. Gabby is, actually. It's the spicy Italian sausage and kale slow cooker soup, and it is a delight. Suspend. How outrageous is it to vamp for Sakura Tribe Elder here? Survey says, not outrageous at all. Classic vamp just gets a basic island every time. Yeah, exactly. Vamp is so bad. It's just unbelievable how bad. The top deck tutors are just bad. Okay. Also, I guess I did have to crack the Misty, so that's my fault, but I still haven't drawn very many islands. Oh, yeah, I guess my game window is slightly off-center. Boom. Oh, I could actually make it slightly bigger. That's what it is. I think that's good. Oh, Thieving Skydiver. That makes me feel very smart, because I thought about getting a Mox Jet at some point here, but of course getting Skur Tribe Builder is just better given I didn't have a 2-mana play anyway. So this is coming down. Oh, this could be a nice Symbiosis game. I think I'm going to Foff now, because I like Foff resolving. Can't steal Mox. Well, that's not true. Not how that card works at all. I think given this hand, I'll just take the Time Warp here. If this deck had a Trop and an Underground Sea, it would be, yes, obscenely much better. So, oh, I love Thieving Skydiver. I think this is just going to be a cube staple. Like, I mean, you don't have to have it, but I think it's just more than earned its place. I think it's cool. So, my Lotus is coming out next turn, and I could Lotus Gearhulk out. We'll see what they do. Daggerhawk, I'm afraid I don't really know. Oh, no, I'm getting Shinobied. Whew. Okay, we got ourselves a game. The good thing is most of my cards are kind of bad. Yeah, they hit double island. Okay. Do-do-do. All right. So, now I kind of wish I took the time, the high tide. But I'm going to just kick things off with a Time Warp. And do I just Twister now? Kind of feel like I do. Drawing Time Twister was actually pretty nice. Now I just get to start my Time Walk turn with 7 new cards. Yeah, I'm going to get to do some things this turn. So... If I cast High Tide and then I cast Witness back... Oh, I have enough to do all of it? I think that's what I'm going to do then. So I'm going to get Island here. Cast High Tide off the Botanical Sanctum. Clutch. Yeah. Witness. This also puts a nice little chump blocker in the way for Shinobi, by the way. High Tide. Yeah. Cast High Tide. Cast Turnabout. Land, untap. And so now I have 11, 14 mana, which means I should probably kick things off with a Foff here, because I see a lot of cards that way. And if I can hit Time Spiral, then... Gearhulk adds tons of mana. All right, so basically Gearhulk is what I'm going to take. If they put Heartbeat and Gearhulk in the same pile, then we're really getting it. Yeah, Cape Scrolls, I really like casting the High Tide off the Botanical Sanctum. It's clutch. All right, so yeah, I'm just going to get Gearhulk because Gearhulk recasts Turnabout. In fact, I actually have enough mana to secure a Tribe Elder for another island first, which is huge. Huge. And then do this. Turnabout. Oh yeah, I almost didn't cast it. That ninja is actually probably not doing anything, is it? Because I'm going to put the ninja back. just in case. And then cast Memory. I guess because if I draw High Tide, I would rather cast it like this. Okay. Memory. And now Brain Freeze is probably just lethal anyway. We didn't get a Turnabout. What are we going to do here? I have access to 7 mana. No, I don't think I want to keep going. I think I just Brain Freeze them and see if it works. Because if it works, we're done. But we'll see. If they have an Eldrazi or something, then we'll have to see, I guess. Turnabout is gone, yeah. Boom! Little trophy action here. that was a clean little turn 5 kill. We got Shinobi'd, but honestly, I actually don't think there's anything they could have Shinobi'd and hit that would have really screwed us except for Turnabout and Time Spiral, and I think I had the Turnabout in my hand already. So there we go. That's how Blue Green Storm does it. That was just a classic Blue Green Storm deck. And if you enjoyed this video, we've got a lot more on channelfireball.com, so check it out.